चीज
On behalf of Kerala General Institute of Dental Sciences, we welcome our today's chief guest, respected Dr. K. Satish Kumar Reddy, sir, ex-ET member, Dental Council of India, President AP State Dental Council, member of Health Reform Committee, Government of Andhra Pradesh. I now welcome our special guest, Mr. Snehit Reddy Meda, sir, CEO, Hala Mobility and People Agritech Private Limited. Our respected secretary, Mr. Y. Man Susan Reddy, sir. I also would take the privilege to welcome Mrs. K. Sindhu, ma'am, treasurer, Kerala Group of Institutions. Our beloved principal, Dr. Vishnu Prakash Shetty, sir. And our director, Dr. G. Nagarjan Reddy, sir. Our PG director, Dr. V. Lakshman Rao, sir. Our esteemed vice principal, Dr. V. Dalsi, sir, and all the heads of the departments. And it's my privilege to welcome the eminent dignitaries of the dais, faculty, parents, postgraduates, postgraduate diploma holders to this 8th convocation ceremony. This institute is built on an ideal vision of a man who wholeheartedly understood the meaning of bringing quality education to the masses. His initiatives stand testimony today on this occasion, which now rejoices in the mission whose vision was envisaged years earlier. Late Dr. K. Lakshma Reddy Garu, fondly known as KLR, is the very foundation on which we stand. I also would like to acknowledge our Honorable Chairperson, Mrs. K. Nagmani Madam, woman, entrepreneur, and educationalist, Lady Legends Lifetime Achievement Awardee, for her benevolence. They enter a simple institution with humble beginnings, an institution craving for excellence and striving for a better future. They were received with open hands to be one family for the days to come and the years to go. They were your children and they became our students. As a testimony to our endeavors, in continuation with NAC Accreditation Aid Committee, stated our institute as modern dental education institution of the region with good social recognition in the region and good academic ambience. Our institute also speaks to the continuous meritorious approach to the performance and achievement in need, standing best at various national and international conferences, conventions, symposia, seminars and ICMR projects. Today is a day of recognition as we acknowledge the success and the achievement of this year's graduating class. Success that has come through personal sacrifice, perseverance and dedication. To the graduates, I am sure that today will be an occasion you remember fondly for the rest of your lives. We are united today by a shared sense of pride in achievement. The college is proud of its graduates, postgraduate diplomates and postgraduates. It is also an important day for parents, families and friends. This achievement is one that is seldom managed without the support of those interests. And today is a celebration which you are very much part of too.
We begin this function invoking the blessings of God Almighty by lighting the lamp. I now request the dignitaries on the dais to kindly proceed to lighten the lamp. I request the congregation to rise up for the invocation.
Thank you.
I invite our beloved principal, Dr. Vishwaprakash Shetty sir, to lead us.
सर इला
I welcome today's chief guest, Dr. Satish Kumar Reddy Garu, President, AP Dental Council. But also welcome guest of honor, Mr. Sanjeev Reddy Keda Garu, CEO of Halal Mobility and Pico Private Limited. Welcome, you, sir. Secretary Madhusudan Reddy Garu, Dr. Nagari Reddy Garu, Vice Principal, PG Director. Authorities of the dais, the graduates, parents, family, and friends, and my dear colleagues, a very warm welcome to all of you on this joyful occasion. We have gathered here today to celebrate your achievements and success. It's a graduation day. The graduation ceremony symbolizes the conversion of lay person to a person that becomes a member of a profession. So in Hindu mythology they say, Vaidya Narayana Hari, meaning to say that you are a god. God means it doesn't mean that everything, whatever he says, you say it should be. Not like that. God means they will follow you. You are a role model, they will look at you, your family, maybe society. The class of 2015 UDs, 2017 postgraduates and 2018 PG diploma batch. Many congratulations to you all. These are exceptional circumstances which makes you exceptional graduates. I do recognize the last few months have been tough for so many of you in so many different ways. But you have adapted, you have remained focused, you have demonstrated resilience and shown true grit. And now, in this moment of immense significance, you are ready to step up and make difference. You have the knowledge, the skills, and most importantly, the humanity to tackle the greatest challenges you will face in your career and life further on. At this point, the person who I like very much would like to quote a great man and influencer of the society, APJ Abdul Kalam. We should know not only how to handle the success, but how to handle the failure also.
PRI.
Failure is the condiment that gives success its flavor. Successful events, your life won't teach you anything. Failure will teach you so many lessons. My dear guests, the journey henceforth is slightly different. So far you learn your lessons and then give your exams. From now onwards, life will give you exams and you will have to learn your lessons. Don't be afraid of failing, but each time you fail, remember to rise again. Each one of you is a great doctor and a global citizen. We know it, your friends know it, and your family know it. But now it is time for you to let the world know it. time for you to begin a new chapter and be the world changers that we already know you can be. It's time to rise to a moment to unleash your potentials, to shape the challenges of our time and carve out a better way. Remember, you will be looked up like a society hereafter. Be the epitomes of role models. Set the right examples. Begin today, we have pandemic shadowing COVID-19. Take the right precautions and measures to keep the virus away. Be responsible citizen. Want to say that what is the biggest learning from this pandemic is nothing is in our hand, but still we need to watch them. Class of 15, 17 and 18, you have reached an important milestone today with a lot of hard work. Congratulations on all that you have achieved. Be proud and celebrate your success. But of course, you have not reached this important day all alone. So join me in showing your appreciation to your parents, family, friends, classmates, your advisors and well-wishers, and most importantly, your mentors. Graduates, whichever trail you decide to blaze, wherever your life takes you, you will always be tied up to us, your alma mater, Lenora Institute of Dental Science. Your presence will be missed in the campus. All the very best, and thank you all of you. Ladies and gentlemen, I present you the outgoing postgraduate batch of 2070, postgraduate diploma batch of 2018, and the undergraduate batch of 2015. Please give them a big round of applause. We now begin with the conferment of degrees to the students and memento to the parents. I request parents to come on to the stage along with their graduates. The name will be read out, and I request each postgraduate and graduate along with family to approach the dais and receive the convocation certificate from the Honorable Chief Guest. Now I kindly request the Chief Guest to open the convocation.
Convocation is declared open.
Now read out the names. Postgraduate students, Dr. Akula Tejaswini,
Dr. Avinash.
అలా తిరుగుతూ రావాలన్నమాట కదా.
డాక్టర్ అవినాష్ డాక్టర్ ప్రణీత డాక్టర్ ప్రణీత
అంజు బాబు అంజు బాబు అది
డాక్టర్ నిరుపమ డాక్టర్ నిరుపమ డాక్టర్ లక్ష్మీనారాయణ డాక్టర్ లక్ష్మీనారాయణ డాక్టర్ కృష్ణ సాహి డాక్టర్ కృష్ణ సాహి డాక్టర్ జంగం రాజేష్ డాక్టర్ రాజేష్ డాక్టర్ కైవల్య
వాయిస్ రావట్లేదు మేడం ఒక్క నిమిషం
డాక్టర్ రాజేష్ డాక్టర్ కైవల్య డాక్టర్ బి
లేఖ డాక్టర్ అమిత్
డాక్టర్ మనోజ్ డాక్టర్ మనోజ్ డాక్టర్ ఇయా మేఘన డాక్టర్ దేవి ఇంద్రగాంధీ డాక్టర్ దేవి ఇంద్రగంటి డాక్టర్ ముప్పై సంధ్య
డాక్టర్
దీక్షిత డాక్టర్ ఐశ్వర్య
ఫోన్ లేదు అదన ఫోన్ అయితే నెత్తు
డాక్టర్ రిషిత
అదేం डॉक्टर विजय कुमार
डॉक्टर विजय कुमार
डॉक्टर कारुण्य डॉक्टर गीतिका
डॉक्टर कुंदना देवी डॉक्टर दुर्गा भवानी डॉक्टर हरिता डॉक्टर गंधम दिव्या सत्यमैरी
Dr. Maiti B. Dr. Harita. Dr. Gangalapu Harita. Dr. Chintala Geeta Reshma. Dr. Chintala Geeta Reshma. Dr. Gongada Nagamonika.
Graduates, please be seated in your chairs. Don't move here and there, no chit chatting please. And no personal photography strictly. Don't raise and take photographs.
Dr. Gorgi Leela Prasanna. Dr. G. Lakshmi Saraswati. Dr. G. Shrami. Dr. Harini. Dr. Glary Parchaya. Dr. Nagala Avanya. J. Triveni. Dr. K. Katusha. Dr. K. Nabina Vaishnavi. Dr. K. Akshita.
చైర్ చూసుకో ఓకే కదా కొంచెం బ్యాక్ తీన
డాక్టర్ కే అక్షిత డాక్టర్ జి లహరి डॉक्टर एल प्रसन्न डॉक्टर एल प्रसन्न
डॉक्टर
इंदुश्री
वाल का है सर
डॉक्टर एम फायर का डॉक्टर एम रत्न सुशीला डॉक्टर एम रत्न सुनीला डॉक्टर एम रेचल दीपिका डॉक्टर मोहम्मद ज़ैबा तक्सुम डॉक्टर तौसीन डॉक्टर तौसीन डॉक्टर एम पद्मिन डॉक्टर एम प्रियंका डॉक्टर एम लक्ष्मी हर्षिता डॉक्टर पी बाबिया डॉक्टर पल्लवी डॉक्टर सौगंधी डॉक्टर पी लीला सुप्रिया डॉक्टर पी प्रियांका Thank you. Dr. Priyanka Bhupati. Dr. Priyanka Bhupati. Dr. R. Vaishnavi. Dr. R. Vaishnavi. Dr. S. P. T. Dr. S. Devithya. Dr. S. K. T. Dr. S. Devithya. Dr. S. Ravi Chandana. Dr. Sheikh Pasha. Dr. Sheikh Pasha. Dr. Sheikh Wasim Basha. Dr. Sheikh Washim Basha. Dr. Shaili. Dr. Harshi. Dr. Arshi. Dr. Arshi. Dr. Saumya. Dr. Saumya. Dr. Saumya. Dr. S. Abhijna. Dr. S. Abhijna. Dr. Naseem.
लगे से अंदर लेट से क्या
डॉक्टर नसीमा डॉक्टर शहनाज Dr. Shahnaz. Dr. U. Isashini. Please maintain silence. Please maintain silence. Dr.
Dr. S. S. Mini, Dr. V. Akshita, Dr. V. Akshita, Dr. V. Bhavya Sri, Dr. V. Bhavya Sri, Dr. V. Durga Saujanya.
Like it. First one, Dala.
Dr. V. Hima Sai Reddy. Dr. V. Vishnu Chandana. Dr. V. Sai Priyanka. Dr. V. Sai Priyanka. Dr. V. Vijay.
Long fast.
Okay, sir.
Dr. Y. Manidi.
Okay.
Dr. Y. Manidi. Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Thank you, sir. We will now present the Academic Excellence Awards to the toppers of the batch. I request all the graduates to come out to the dais and receive the awards. Parents, please be seated. Please switch off mode. Daichesi under my phone, switch off Chelsea on Chandi. Don't take any photographs also. Please maintain silence. I now request our chief guest, Dr. K. Satish Kumar Reddy, sir, to come forward to present awards of excellence. The award for securing university first rank in the MDS examination 2019-20 goes to Dr. V. Avinash, and university second rank goes to Dr. K. Pranita, and university third rank goes to Dr. Y. Sai Nirupama from the Department of Public Health Industry. Second rank in MDS examination goes to Dr. V. Monikam from the Department of Orthodontics.
Okay.
The award for securing university third rank in MDS examination goes to Dr. G. V. Joseph, and the university fourth rank goes to Dr. Satya Sai Shruti from the Department of Prosthodontics. The award for securing university second rank in MDS examination goes to Dr. Saila Reddy from the Department of Periodontics.
Mahanka, mask.
the award for securing university
four
times. Dr. V. Krishna Sahi from the Department of Oral Medicine.
Okay. Okay, madam.
Okay.
Thank you, sir. I now request Mr. Snehit Reddy, sir, to come forward to present the awards of excellence. I invite Dr. G. Shravani for securing the highest score in anatomy to receive her award. I invite Dr. S. C. T. for securing the highest score in dental materials to receive her award. I invite Dr. M. Aishwaryam for securing the highest score in general medicine to receive her award. I invite Dr. R. Vaishnavi for securing the highest score in anatomy, physiology, and biochemistry, pediatric and preventive dentistry, and for securing the university second rank to receive her award. I invite Dr. Balaji Maunika for securing the highest score in oral medicine and radiology and for securing university rank, third rank in the university to receive her award.
I invite Dr. K. Navina Vaishnavi for securing the highest score in general surgery and overall topper in third year and for securing university first rank to receive her award.
I invite Dr. V. Krishnachandana for securing university first rank in the BDS examination to receive our award. I invite Dr. P. Harvey for securing university 12th rank in the BDS examination to receive our award.
I invite Dr. G. Lakshmi Saraswati for securing the highest score in DADH, physiology and biochemistry, pharmacology, microbiology, general pathology, oral pathology, orthodontics, conservative dentistry and endodontics, oral and maxillofacial surgery, public health dentistry, oral medicine and radiology, periodontics, and overall topper in first, second, and final year of DADH, and for securing university first rank to receive her award.
I now request our special guest, Mr. Snehit Reddy sir, to present the KLR gold medal and a cash prize to Dr. G. Lakshmi Saraswati, the best outgoing student. I request her parents to receive an award.
I now request our special guest, Mr. Snehit Reddy sir, to present the KLR gold medal and cash prize to Dr. G. Lakshmi Saraswati, the best outgoing student.
Sir, it's Jordan.
Let's go, sir. Okay, thank you.
Thank you, sir. All our activities should be governed by the light of knowledge, especially the knowledge of dharma. By this knowledge, ignorance or darkness is dispelled. I request all the students to rise for taking the physician's oath according to the Declaration of Geneva. I request the Honorable Chief Guest, Dr. K. Satish Kumar Reddy sir, to deliver the oath to the graduates, postgraduates and postgraduate diplomas.
Thank you.
Raise your right hand. It is just a ritual to take this oath, but now you are qualified doctors and your responsibility is more than this oath, much more than this oath. And you know what are your responsibilities as a medical practitioner. As your principal said, it is a noble profession. All the doctors are considered a lot of respect after the God. So consider that in your mind, take this oath and try to practice more than this what is possible. Now I take the oath and you just spell it after me. I solemnly pledge to consecrate my life to the service of humanity. I will give to my teachers the respect and gratitude that they are due. I will practice my profession with consciousness and dignity. Health of my patient will be my first consideration. I will respect the secrets confined in me, even after the death of patient has died. I will maintain by all means in my power the honor and the noble traditions of the medical and dental profession. My colleagues will be my sisters and brothers. I will not permit considerations of age, desire or disability, creed, ethnic origin, gender, nationality, political affiliations, race, sexual orientation, and social standing, or any other factor to intervene between my duty and my patient. I will maintain the utmost respect for the human life. I will not use my medical knowledge to violate human rights and civil liabilities. Even under any threat. I make these promises solemnly, freely, and upon my honor. Thank you. You can raise it up.
Thank you, sir. I now request respected Chief Guest to announce the convocation is closed.
I declare this convocation is closed.
I now invite our PG Director, Dr. D. Lakshman Rao, sir, to speak a few words.
Respected dignitaries on the dais, my colleague faculty members, the happy parents, and today's celebrities, both graduates and postgraduate, good afternoon to good evening. Let me congratulate the young bright students who have turned dental surgeons and others who have been conferred the Master of Dental Surgery and PG Diploma. I see exhilaration and sense of achievement in them, which they truly deserve after years of hard work. Of course, I also see the pride and sense of fulfillment on the faces of their parents. You have received a great education here, and I have very confidence that you will successfully meet the challenges of tomorrow. This day is about you. You have completed the longest leg in your life, journey of to be a dental surgeon as well as a specialist graduate. A special congratulations for this MDS batch who secured 8 university rank. It was, when the results were announced, it was counted. It's like 1, 1, 1, then 2, 2, 2, and it went on to 8. And our secretary sir was counting, and we are giving feedback, sir, our department, our department, our department. I congratulate all of you. The graduates long back you achieved, that's why we already praised many times. Today, as you contemplate your journey ahead, I believe each of you will be challenged to be an equibrist. That means, who does a balancing act? As you leave this college, you begin a journey that will test you as an equibrist on the tightrope of life. To pave your path of success honestly and take pride in passing out from this prestigious institution. All your achievements in this institution will be on record forever. As you leave the portals of this prestigious institution today, be assured that the intellectual, social, and technical skills you have acquired here from the teachers would stand you in good position in this society. Your parents, teachers, and alma mater will be proud of you, your achievements. But there will be a higher calling in your life. Be an exemplary, but be modest in your life. You are venturing into a noble profession like medicine. In society, a doctor is accorded the status of a god. So Vaidya Narayana Hari. So honor the trust that people will repose in you. Honor the Hippocratic Oath. Use your knowledge and technical expertise for the welfare of common men. Today, the technology growing with rocket speed. You need to update the latest technology in your field. Hence, attend seminars and CDE programs regularly to update your knowledge. Finally, I am concluding with Shatamanam Bhavati. So, Andaru, Aarogyanga, Santoshanga Undala. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. I now invite our esteemed Vice Principal, sir, Dr. V. Dal Singh, to speak a few words.
Respected dignitaries on the dais, respected heads of the departments, my dear colleagues, graduates and parents, good evening all, and hearty congratulations to all the graduates and postgraduates and diploma students. It's really a happy moment. At the same time, end of the happiest moments. It's a happy moment, but end of the happiest moments, because you are no more paid for your kiddish fees. You are no more a child. You are a graduate, responsible adult. You have to take care of your family members and many things. So I would like to stress here very few points. Number one, don't run for the success. Work hard. The success will follow you. Be ethical in your practice. Number two, number three, health is wealth. During this pandemic, even wealth could not save many lives. So ఎంత డబ్బు సంపాదించినా కానీ మన హెల్త్ కాపాడకపోతే అది వేస్ట్. సో ట్రై టు మెయింటైన్ గుడ్ హెల్త్ ఫ్రమ్ నౌ ఇట్ సెల్ఫ్. బీ ఫిట్, హ్యావ్ రెగ్యులర్ వాక్స్ అండ్ మెయింటైన్ గుడ్ హెల్త్. అండ్ లాస్ట్ బట్ నాట్ ద లీస్ట్, టేక్ కేర్ ఆఫ్ యువర్ పేరెంట్స్, బికాస్ మెజారిటీ ఆఫ్ యువర్ గర్ల్స్ డోంట్ ఫోర్స్ యువర్ would be to stay away from you when you get married. Don't put such conditions. పెళ్ళైన తర్వాత అందరూ అమ్మాయిలు ఉన్నారు కాబట్టి చెప్తున్నాను, పెళ్ళి చేసుకున్న తర్వాత మీ అమ్మా నాన్నలు మా దగ్గర ఉండకూడదు అని కండిషన్లు పెట్టకండి. బికాజ్ దే ఆర్ నాట్ యూస్ టు, దే ఆర్ నాట్ ప్రిపేర్డ్ ఫర్ ఓల్డ్ ఏజ్ హోమ్ ఐ గెస్. ఇప్పుడు ఈ జనరేషన్ వాళ్ళు, అంటే మా జనరేషన్ వాళ్ళు ఆల్మోస్ట్ ప్రిపేర్డ్, కానీ మీ జనరేషన్ వాళ్ళు వదిలేయకండి, వాళ్ళని బాగా చూసుకోండి. థ్యాంక్ యూ సో మచ్.
Thank you, sir, for your caring and inspiring words.
May I now call upon our director, Dr. Nagarjun Reddy Garu, to address the gathering.
Respected dignitaries on the dais, off the dais, HODs, faculty members, the parents, and the today's the celebrities of the graduates. Good afternoon to one and all, and hearty congratulations to all the graduates who received the certificates and mementos today. ఇందులో మీ అందరిది, అండర్ గ్రాడ్యుయేట్స్ది ఈ కేఎల్ఆర్ లెనోరా ఇన్స్టిట్యూట్లో 5 ఇయర్స్ జర్నీ అయితే, పోస్ట్ గ్రాడ్యుయేట్స్ 3 ఇయర్స్ జర్నీ, పోస్ట్ గ్రాడ్యుయేట్ డిప్లొమా వాళ్ళు 2 ఇయర్స్ జర్నీ. మీరు చేసింది 2 ఇయర్స్ అయినా 5 ఇయర్స్ అయినా, బట్ లైఫ్ లాంగ్ మీరు లెనోరా స్టూడెంట్స్. లైఫ్ లాంగ్ మీరు లెనోరా స్టూడెంట్స్. అండ్ ఇక్కడున్న ఫ్యాకల్టీ కానివ్వండి, ద మేనేజ్మెంట్ కానీ చేంజ్ అవ్వచ్చు, ఎలా అయినా వెళ్ళచ్చు, కానీ మీరు ఎక్కడికి పోయినా కానీ ఎప్పుడైనా లెనోర్ రిఫరెన్స్ వస్తే మా కాలేజ్ అని మీరు చెప్తారు గర్వంగా, అవునా కదా? సో వేర్ ఎవర్ యు గో, లీవ్ యువర్ ఇంప్రెషన్, వాట్ ఎవర్ యూ లెర్న్ ఫ్రమ్ దీస్ 5 ఇయర్స్ ఆర్ 3 ఇయర్స్ ఆర్ 2 ఇయర్స్, ఎన్నో బెటర్ ఎక్స్పీరియన్సెస్ ఉండొచ్చు, అలానే బ్లిస్ఫుల్ ఎక్స్పీరియన్సెస్ కూడా ఉంటాయి. వీటన్నింటిని ఎవరేసుకుంటూ ఎక్కడికి వెళ్ళినా కానీ ఈ అకాడమిక్ అవార్డ్స్ రివార్డ్స్ అవి వన్స్ అగైన్ కంగ్రాచులేట్ ఆల్ ద విన్నర్స్. అట్ ద సేమ్ టైం ఎనీ పేషెంట్ హాస్పిటల్కి వస్తే డాక్టర్ గారు డిస్టింక్షన్లో పాస్ అయ్యారా, జస్ట్ పాస్ అయ్యారు, సెకండ్ క్లాస్ పాస్, ఎవరు అడగరు డాక్టర్ గారు ఉన్నారా లేదంటారు. అక్కడ వచ్చింది మౌనికానా, ఇంకొక శ్రీనివాస, ఇంకొక పేర్లు కూడా అడగరు, డాక్టర్ గారు ఉన్నారా లేదా, డాక్టర్ గారు నాకు ఇది బాధ. సో అది గుర్తు పెట్టుకొని ఎప్పుడూ కూడా మీరు మంచిగా మంచి సర్వీస్ ఇస్తూ సమాజంలో మీరు మంచి డాక్టర్లుగా స్థిరపడాలని కోరుకుంటూ ఐ వన్స్ అగైన్ కంగ్రాచులేట్ ఆల్ ద గ్రాడ్యుయేట్స్. అండ్ మీ అందరినీ ఇంత కష్టపడి ఈ లెవెల్కి తీసుకొచ్చి ఈరోజు కూడా మీరు గ్రాడ్యుయేషన్ తీసుకుంటుంటే వాళ్ళ ఆనందం మీ పేరెంట్స్ కళ్ళలో చూస్తున్నాము. అంత కష్టపడి ఇంత తుఫాన్లో కూడా వాళ్ళు కష్టపడి దూరం వచ్చి మీ సక్సెస్ వాళ్ళు చూడాలని, అంటే ప్రతి స్టేజ్లో మీరు ఫస్ట్ స్టాండర్డ్ ఎల్కేజీ నుండి యూకేజీ నుండి కానీ ప్రతి ఇయర్ కూడా మీరు చూస్తూనే ఉన్నారు, మీ సక్సెస్ఏ వాళ్ళ సక్సెస్. సో కీప్ ఇట్ దట్ అండ్ టేక్ కేర్ ఆఫ్ యువర్ సెల్ఫ్ అండ్ బీ ఏ గుడ్ డాక్టర్. థ్యాంక్ యూ, థ్యాంక్ యూ అన్నాడు.
థ్యాంక్ యూ సార్.
Now I invite our Honorable Treasurer, Kerala Group of Institutions, Mrs. K. Sindhu Ma'am, to address the gathering.
Good evening to the dignitaries on the stage and to all the HODs and staff, parents and students. Firstly, congratulations on graduating and getting so many university ranks. And it's really a strange time to graduate considering the pandemic. And I think looking at the silver linings, you'll be going out into the world and then practicing the best hygiene practices you can ever do in dentistry. So it's kind of a blessing because your power level is at the top to maintain the hygiene levels. And once you start your practice, it's a good start because you already have a power level set for quality practice. And so there are a few things I would add to Dal Singh Sir's list. As you've taken the oath, it is very important, like the dentistry right now, it is very important to make a differentiation when you graduate. So the differentiation happens, a lot of people are having quality practices, but then the differentiation comes with patient hospitality. So someone asked me what's patient hospitality, like what's hospitality even related to dentistry. The whole oath you took just right now is about hospitality. So till now you've treated patients, but after a 1 week, if the patient goes home and we chase in a feeling him and apartheid, they'll come back and say, oh, some student in the college did it, so next time I'll go to a doctor. But right now you don't have that privilege because you will not be students anymore, but you will be doctors. So for you to maintain that patient relationship, it is very important to avoid those mistakes and focus very much on developing individual patient relationships. So your senior batch, I had privilege to go with them to the exchange program in Malaysia for a week, and then they were very surprised at only one thing. So in Malaysia, it was very hard for them to find patients. So they had like in ortho department, really they had one patient coming in. So they really treated their patient as God. So the patient comes and then like, we want some water, meat and all. So they take a lot of good care. And our students were so surprised because they were like, he's just treating one patient for past few hours. We would have treated 4 or 5 patients by now. What are these people doing? But that's where the dentistry is heading, because for you to make a differentiation and excel as a dentist, I think it's very important to focus on maintaining those relationships and bringing more humanity into the whole industry itself. And I would like to recall the vision and mission of Dr. Late Taylor, sir, on this occasion, because your 5 years of journey, I just want to make a quick recap of what management has been trying to do, and I want you to take few takeaways from the management struggle and vision. So I just want to do a quick 2-point recap. The first one is, as your principal has said, patients treat you as God. So I would like to say you also should start treating your patients as God, because it is very important to maintain quality in the treatment you do, even in the materials you do. So last year we were trying to procure more supplies for the college practices, and then we had a meeting with the HODs, and not even one HOD was ready. They all wanted the best available brands of the materials available in the market. They were like, no, we need a 3M compound, so we need a 3M. We don't really bother about the cost, expenses or anything. We want what's best for the students. So what the HODs were trying to do was teach the students to use the best available materials. It was a free service to hundreds of patients you do every day. But then what they wanted to impart through this college was to ensure that you maintain quality service throughout. Even if it's a free service or if you're charging for it, nevertheless, just make sure that you treat patient as God. Once you start treating your patient as God, if you start doing a filling, you won't be like, okay, I'm doing a free treatment, so let's use some other brand materials, but you would always want to do best treatment for the God, do best hospitality for God. So that is what the HOD and the staff and management was trying to impart by spending so much even while doing free treatments. And the second thing is the vision of Lakshma Reddy Garu. to ensure that there is always social services imparted through education and to impart values through education. So that's exactly why you were privileged to treat so many patients freely, and you had so much patient exposure every day. Almost you have 300, 400 patients, the highest OP in the whole state, and you're so privileged because all the treatments are given free and then the quality of the treatment is so high. So with this, I would want you to take the same inspiration, and wherever and whenever possible, I would like you to impart, lend a hand to people whoever are in need, and then remember the college days where you've treated so many people for free, and whenever possible, just lend your hand and try to help them. And if while lending your hand, if you do something good for the people, you'll always have a smile in your face. And if in that smile, if you can remember Dr. Kerala Garu, that will be the success for college's mission. And that's what I would want to tell you while graduating. Thank you, and all the best for the new future.
Thank you, ma'am, for your uniting and thoughtful words.
I request our secretary, Kerala Group of Institutions, Mr. Y. Madhusudan Reddy Garu, to share his thoughts with us on this special day.
Graduations ceremony ki mukhya adhikariga vichesinatvanti Dr. K. Satish Kumar Reddy gariki pratyeka atithi Snehit Reddy gariki itara atithulu principal Vishwa Prakash Reddy gariki HOD inati graduating students ki గ్రాడ్యుయేటింగ్ పీజీస్కి వారి తల్లిదండ్రులకి అందరికి కూడా ఈ కార్యక్రమానికి ఇంత ధైర్యంగా సిద్ధ చేసినందుకు నా ధన్యవాదాలు. ఎందుకంటే ఇది ఒక ప్రత్యేకమైన సందర్భం కాబట్టి, ఒక ప్రత్యేకమైన పరిస్థితి. ఇటువంటి ప్రత్యేకమైన పరిస్థితులలో ఈ కార్యక్రమాన్ని నిర్వహించడం కూడా ఒక ప్రత్యేకతే. ఆ ప్రత్యేకతలో కూడా ఇంతమంది ఒక్కరు కూడా అంటే ఒకళ్ళిద్దరు పాపం రాలేకపోయారు సమయానికి, ఆయన అన్ని దాటుకుంటూ అంటే ఒకరిని చూస్తే ఇంకొకరికి ఇన్స్పిరేషన్ వస్తుంది, ఇంకొకళ్ళు వచ్చారంటే ఇంకొకరు చూస్తే అట్లాగే అందరూ మ్యాక్సిమం అటెండెన్స్ అందరూ కూడా మీ అందరికీ ధన్యవాదాలు. నేను రాలేమో ఇంతమంది అనుకున్నాను, తల్లిదండ్రులు కూడా చక్కగా వచ్చారు, వారికి కూడా పేరు పేరున నా కృతజ్ఞతలు. సో ఇందాక పీజీ డైరెక్టర్ గారు పాపం ఆయన పీజీ డైరెక్టర్ గారు కాబట్టి పీజీ ర్యాంకుల గురించే చెప్పారు. మాకు ఒకటి 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 వచ్చాయి, రెండు 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 వచ్చాయి, మూడు 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 వచ్చాయి కాదు కాదు, యూజీ వాళ్ళకి కూడా ఈ బ్యాచ్లో చాలా ర్యాంకులు వచ్చాయి. ఒకటి 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 వాళ్ళకి వచ్చింది, రెండు 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 వచ్చింది. ఒకసారి గట్టిగా చప్పట్ల ద్వారా వారికి కూడా ధన్యవాదాలు తెలియజేసి, మరి ముఖ్యంగా యూనివర్సిటీ టాప్ స్టూడెంట్ ఈరోజు మధ్య ఇక్కడ అందుబాటులో లేకపోవటం వారి తల్లి వారి ఫాదర్ వచ్చారు సరస్వతి గారు ఫాదర్, వారికి కూడా ప్రత్యేకమైన ధన్యవాదాలు. ఫ్లైట్ తీసుకొని రమ్మా అని అడిగాను పాపం, ఫ్లైట్ ఎక్కేసి వచ్చేసే ఏం కాదు, వచ్చినా వెళ్ళిపోదు అని. సో కేఎల్ఆర్స్ లెనరా ఇన్స్టిట్యూట్ ఆఫ్ డెంటల్ సైన్సెస్ 2008లో ప్రారంభించిన నాటి నుంచి ఈనాటి వరకు 2020 12 సంవత్సరాల ఈ ప్రయాణంలో, ఈ సుదీర్ఘ ప్రయాణంలో కేఎల్ఆర్ గారి తర్వాత విద్యా సంస్థకి మూల స్తంభం ముఖ్యమైన వ్యక్తి డాక్టర్ సతీష్ కుమార్ రెడ్డి గారు. వారు వారు లేకపోతే ఆల్మోస్ట్ కేఎల్ఆర్ గారు లేకపోతే ఎలాగైతే ఇన్స్టిట్యూషన్ వచ్చేది కాదు, వారు లేకపోయినా కానీ ఇన్స్టిట్యూషన్ వచ్చేది కాదు. అంటే ఒకటో డే వన్, ఇది ఇన్సెప్షన్ అయిన డే వన్, దానికంటే ముందు నుంచి కూడా నుంచి ఈరోజు వరకు వారి సహాయ సహకారాలు, వారి సలహా సంప్రదింపులు లేకుండా ఏ కార్యక్రమం కూడా చేపట్టే అవకాశం లేదు. రీసెంట్గా వారు ఆంధ్రప్రదేశ్ స్టేట్ డెంటల్ కౌన్సిల్ ప్రెసిడెంట్ కావటం, ఆ తర్వాత డెంటల్ కౌన్సిల్ ఆఫ్ ఇండియా మెంబర్ కావటం, మన కాలేజీలో డీన్గా కూడా బాధ్యతలు చేపట్టడం మనందరి అదృష్టం. వారికి ఈ సందర్భంగా ధన్యవాదాలు, శుభాకాంక్షలు. ఈ మొత్తం ప్రయాణంలో మరీ ముఖ్యంగా 2015 బ్యాచ్కు ప్రత్యేకత ఉంది. మీరు అనుకునే ప్రత్యేకత కాదు, అంటే ఇండిసిప్లిన్ లేకపోతే మిస్టేక్ చేయటం కాదు, అది కాదు. లేదు, మొట్టమొదటి 100 మంది తోటి ప్రారంభించిన మొట్టమొదటి అంటే అంతకుముందు 60 మందే ఉండేవాళ్ళు ఈ బ్యాచ్కి ముందు. తర్వాత అనుకోకుండా దురదృష్టవశాత్తు కేఎల్ఆర్ గారు చనిపోయిన తర్వాత కాలేజ్ ఫినాన్షియల్ సస్టైనబిలిటీ అట్లా ఆర్థికంగా ఎటువంటి ఒడిదుడుకులు లేకుండా కాలేజీ నడపాలి అని అంటే అప్పుడు సతీష్ కుమార్ రెడ్డి గారు ఇచ్చిన సలహా ఏంటంటే 100 మంది విద్యార్థులు తీసుకోవడానికి మనం ప్రయత్నం చేద్దామని చెప్పి ఆయన వితిన్ 3 నెలల నుంచి 4 నెలల కాల వ్యవధిలోనే 100 మంది విద్యార్థులు తీసుకోవడానికి డీసీఐ అప్రూవల్ ఇవ్వడం జరిగింది. ఆ రకంగా ఈ 2015 బ్యాచ్ వాళ్ళు ఇక్కడ మాకు ఈ రోజున గ్రాడ్యుయేట్ చేయడం జరిగింది. అంటే అది మీ ప్రత్యేకత. అది కాకుండా మీరు అనుకునే ప్రతి ప్రత్యేకత కూడా మీకు ప్రత్యేకతే. మీరు చేసినంత హడావుడి, మీరు చేసినంత అల్లరి, మీరు చేసినంత దానికి కూడా తప్పని పడుతుంటారా? అంటే మీరు చదివినంత బాగా కూడా ఎవరు చదివినట్టు లేదు కదా, మీరు తెచ్చిన ర్యాంకులు ఎవరో తీసుకురాలేదు. కొద్దిగా ఒక గంట సేపు మొరాయించినా కానీ తర్వాత చెప్పిన పని చెప్పినట్టు చేసేవాళ్ళు. స్టడీ అవర్స్కి రావాలంటే స్టడీ అవర్స్కి రావటం, 2 అంటే ఆ 100 మంది బ్యాచ్ అందరూ కూడా వచ్చిన వాళ్ళందరూ గ్రాడ్యుయేట్ అవ్వాలని ఏకైక ఉద్దేశంతో మేము ఇంకా క్లోజ్గా ఫాలో అప్ చేసి మీ అందరూ కంపల్సరీ, అంటే ఏదైతే 4th ఇయర్కి వచ్చారో వాళ్ళు ఎవరూ ఫెయిల్ కాకూడదనే ఏకైక ఉద్దేశంతో, అంటే మొట్టమొదటి 100 బ్యాచ్ అవటం వల్ల ఆ రకమైన కేర్ తీసుకొని మిమ్మల్ని చదివించడం జరిగింది. మీరు కూడా అట్లాగే స్పందించి చదివి పాస్ అయ్యి ఈ రోజున ఇలా మా ముందు గ్రాడ్యుయేషన్ ఇవ్వటం నాకు, నాకు ముఖ్యంగా మా యజమాన్యానికి, మా ప్రిన్సిపాల్ గారికి, మా స్టాఫ్ అందరికి కూడా చాలా గర్వకారణం. అలాగే పోస్ట్ గ్రాడ్యుయేట్ స్టూడెంట్స్ కూడా అసలు ఇమాజిన్ చేయలేదు. నేను ఏదైనా ఒక్కొక్క డిపార్ట్మెంట్లో ఒక ర్యాంక్ వస్తుందనుకుంటే అది వచ్చేసి ఏదో ర్యాంకులు వరదలాగా వచ్చేసింది, ర్యాంకులు వరదలాగా వచ్చింది. దాంట్లో కూడా ఎప్పటి నుంచి యూజీ పీజీ కూడా చదివిన ఒక ఇద్దరు స్టూడెంట్స్కి సైదారెడ్డి మౌనిక వాళ్ళకి కూడా ర్యాంకులు రావటం, ఒక కాలేజీలో 5 సంవత్సరాల మందికి అమ్మ ఇంకో కాలేజీలో వెళ్ళిపోవాలనుకుంటారు పాపం వాళ్ళిద్దరు కూడా దాదాపు 9 సంవత్సరాల కాలం ఒకే కాలేజీలో ఇదే కాలేజీలో ఉన్నారంటే వాళ్ళకి కూడా ఈ సందర్భంగా శుభాకాంక్షలు తెలియజేస్తున్నాను. ముఖ్యంగా పోస్ట్ గ్రాడ్యుయేట్స్కి కెరీర్ ఎహెడ్ చెప్పే అవసరం లేదు. వారికి ఈ పాటికి మొత్తం వ్యవస్థ, సమాజం అన్నీ అర్థమైపోయి ఉంటాయి. కానీ సమస్యల్లో వచ్చేది అండర్ గ్రాడ్ స్టూడెంట్స్కే. మీరు నెక్స్ట్ బయటకు వెళ్తే ఏంటి, ఏం చేయాలనేది కొంచెం టైం తీసుకొని, ఒక టైం గ్యాప్ తీసుకొని ఆలోచించుకొని సరైన నిర్ణయం తీసుకొని సరైన దిశగా, అంటే రకరకాల ప్రాక్టికల్స్ చేయకుండా, రకరకాల ఆలోచనలు చేయకుండా ఒక స్థిరమైన ఆలోచన చేసి మీరు ఒక నిర్ణయం తీసుకొని, అంటే పోస్ట్ గ్రాడ్యుయేషన్ ప్రిపేర్ అవ్వాలి అంటే పోస్ట్ గ్రాడ్యుయేషన్ ప్రాపర్గా ప్రిపేర్ అవ్వాలి, లేదా అబ్రాడ్ వెళ్ళాలంటే అబ్రాడ్కి వెళ్ళడానికి కావాల్సిన SOPs ఏంటి, లేదు గవర్నమెంట్ జాబ్ ట్రై చేయాలంటే గవర్నమెంట్ జాబ్కి కావాల్సిన ఎటువంటి ప్రిపరేషన్ జరగాలి, ఏదైనా ప్రాక్టీస్ చేయాలి అంటే ప్రాక్టీస్ చేయడానికి కావాల్సిన ముఖ్యమైన విషయాలు ఏంటి, ప్రాక్టీస్ చేయడానికి కావాల్సిన సరంజామా ఏంటి, ప్రాక్టీస్ చేయాల్సిన కావాల్సిన అనుభవం కానీ అనుభవం కానీ పద్ధతులు కానీ మీరు అందరూ తెలుసుకొని ఆ తర్వాత కొంచెం గ్యాప్ తీసుకొని మీరు ముందుకెళ్తే అది చాలా అంటే లైఫ్లో మళ్ళీ వెనక్కి తిరిగి చూడాల్సిన అవసరం లేకుండా మీరు అంటే ఉదాహరణకి ప్రాక్టీస్ పెట్టారనుకోండి, మీరు ఈ సందర్భంలో ఈ పరిస్థితులలో సంవత్సరం పాటు నెలకి ఒక్కరు లేదా ఇద్దరు పేషెంట్స్ వస్తారని లెక్క వేసుకుని ప్రాక్టీస్ పెట్టారు. సస్టైనబిలిటీ అంటే మీరు అదే ఏరియాలో ఆ ప్రాక్టీస్ని ఎట్లా సస్టైన్ చేసిన రోజునే అప్పుడే మీకు తిరిగి ఫీడ్బ్యాక్ పేషెంట్ ఫీడ్బ్యాక్ రావటం మొదలవుతుంది. అంతేగాని నేను హాస్పిటల్ ఓపెన్ చేసిన నెక్స్ట్ డే నుంచి నాకు పేషెంట్ రావాలని మనం ఎక్స్పెక్ట్ చేయకూడదు. మీరు ఇక్కడ ఓన్లీ అకాడమిక్స్ మాత్రమే చదువుకొని ఉంటారు కానీ అకాడమిక్స్ అక్కడ పోయిన తర్వాత ఇక్కడ తగిన స్కిల్స్ అన్నీ అక్కడ పోయిన తర్వాత 50% ఉంటాయి. 50% అన్నీ కూడా మీ కమ్యూనికేషన్ స్కిల్స్ మీద ఆధారపడండి. నాకు తెలుసు మీలో మెజారిటీ స్టూడెంట్స్ పేషెంట్తో డీల్ చేయటం ఆల్రెడీ వచ్చి ఉండాలి మీకున్న ఎక్స్పోజర్కి. అయినా కానీ ఇక్కడ ఏంటంటే మీ పైన భాష తీసుకునే వాళ్ళు ఒకళ్ళు ఉంటారు, మీ ఫ్యాకల్టీయో మీ హెచ్ఓడియో, కానీ అక్కడ మీరే బాధ్యులు కాబట్టి ప్రతిదీ కూడా జాగ్రత్తగా వ్యవహరించి పేషెంట్ని కౌన్సిల్ చేసి మీకు కావాల్సిన ట్రీట్మెంట్ వైపు మౌల్డ్ చేసి అక్కడి నుంచి మీరు ముందుకెళ్ళే ఆలోచన చేయాలి. అది చాలా ముఖ్యమైన విషయం. అంటే ఓన్లీ 50% మాత్రమే మీ స్కిల్స్ పనిచేస్తాయి, మిగిలిన 50% ఈ కమ్యూనికేషన్ స్కిల్స్ అవసరం అవుతాయి. ఇక దురదృష్టవశాత్తు మేము 2-3 ప్రోగ్రామ్స్ అట్లాంటివి పెడదాం అని అనుకున్నాము, స్టూడెంట్ ఎక్స్చేంజ్ ప్రోగ్రామ్, తర్వాత అబ్రాడ్ విజిట్, వేరే క్లినిక్స్ విజిట్ అట్లాంటివి పెడదాం అనుకున్నాం, కానీ ఈ ప్రత్యేక పరిస్థితులు రావటం వల్ల సాధ్యపడలేదు. అయినా కానీ ఇద్దరు ముగ్గురు తల్లిదండ్రులు ఫోన్ చేసినప్పుడు చెప్పాను నేను, పరిస్థితులన్నీ అనుకూలిస్తే మార్చి లేదా ఏప్రిల్ తర్వాత బ్యాచ్ వైజ్ ఒక 2-2 మంత్స్ డిఫరెంట్ క్లినికల్ సబ్జెక్ట్స్లో పోస్టింగ్ వేసి మీరు ఇప్పుడు ఏదైతే కోల్పోయారో, 6 నెలల కాలంలో మీ క్లినికల్ ఎక్స్పోజర్ ఏదైతే కోల్పోయామని అనుకుంటున్నారో దాన్ని తప్పకుండా మీరు కాంపెన్సేట్ చేసేదానికి ఆలోచన చేశాం. ఎట్టి పరిస్థితుల్లో మీ అందరికి కూడా మళ్ళీ తిరిగి ఇదే కాలేజీలో అన్ని డిపార్ట్మెంట్లు అంటే క్లినికల్ డిపార్ట్మెంట్స్ అన్నింటిలో ఎక్స్పోజర్ వచ్చే అవకాశాన్ని అరేంజ్మెంట్ చేశాము. మీరెవరు కూడా ఆందోళన చెందాల్సిన అవసరం లేదు, తల్లిదండ్రులు కూడా ఎటువంటి ఆందోళన చెందాల్సిన అవసరం లేదు. తప్పకుండా అవకాశం మీకు ఉంటుంది. అదే కాకుండా దగ్గరలో ఉండి అవకాశం ఉన్న వాళ్ళు ఎవరైనా సరే ఎప్పుడైతే రీఓపెనింగ్ అవుతుందో అప్పుడు కావాలంటే మీరు పర్మిషన్ తీసుకొని మీరు అప్పుడు కూడా క్లినిక్స్కి అటెండ్ అవ్వడానికి మాకు ఎటువంటి అభ్యంతరం లేదు. మీకు కావాల్సిన పోస్టింగ్ ప్రిన్సిపల్ గారు ఎక్కడంటే అక్కడ చూసి మీకు అటువంటి పోస్టింగ్ అవకాశం ఇస్తారు. కొంచెం పరిస్థితులన్నీ చక్కబడ్డ తర్వాత ఆ కార్యక్రమాన్ని చేపట్టడానికి మనం ప్రయత్నం చేద్దాం. అది ఆ ప్రొవిజన్ మీకు కంపల్సరీ ఉంటుంది. అదే కాకుండా మీరు ఇప్పుడు ఈ సందర్భంగా మనందరం నేర్చుకుంది ఏంటంటే మనం టెక్నాలజీ ఓరియంటెడ్ లెర్నింగ్ వైపు షిఫ్ట్ అవ్వాలి. ఇంతకుముందు ఫేస్ టు ఫేస్ ఇంటరాక్షన్, క్లాస్ రూమ్ ఇంటరాక్షన్ అట్లాంటివి ఉండేవి కదా. ఇప్పుడు మీరు నీట్ ప్రిపేర్ అయ్యే వాళ్ళకి ఇదే సరైన సమయం. ఇది చాలా వండర్ఫుల్ గ్యాప్. మీకు ఈ అవకాశాన్ని ఉపయోగించుకొని ఆన్లైన్ లేదా ఆఫ్లైన్ లేదా కంప్యూటర్ బేస్డ్ టెస్టుల ద్వారా నేర్చుకొని నీట్ ఎగ్జామ్ రాయగలిగితే రాబోయే రోజుల్లో గవర్నమెంట్ జాబ్స్ కూడా నీట్ ఎగ్జామ్నే ప్రాముఖ్యంగా తీసుకునే అవకాశం ఉంది. కాబట్టి మీరు నీట్ ఎగ్జామ్ రాయగలిగితే అది కూడా మీకు కాస్త కొంత ఉపయోగపడుతుంది. దాని మీద కూడా దృష్టి పెడితే మీకు కొంచెం మీరు కోల్పోయింది కొంచెం మీరు తిరిగి తెచ్చుకునే అవకాశం ఉంటుంది. కాబట్టి దాని మీద కూడా దృష్టి పెట్టవలసింది అవుతుంది. ఈ ముఖ్యంగా తల్లిదండ్రులకు చెప్పేది ఏంటంటే పిల్లలు అంటే ఇప్పుడు దాకా మా దగ్గర ఉన్నారు, మ్యాక్సిమం హాస్టల్లో ఉన్నారు, లేదు మేము చూస్తూ ఉన్నాము, కానీ ఇక్కడ నుంచి వాళ్ళకి మీ సహాయ సహకారాలు అవసరం అవుతాయి. తల్లిదండ్రుల యొక్క సహాయ సహకారాలు వాళ్ళని కొంచెం క్లోజ్గా అబ్జర్వ్ చేస్తూ ఉండండి. వాళ్ళు ఏం నెక్స్ట్ ఏమనుకుంటున్నారు, నెక్స్ట్ ఏమి చేయాలనుకుంటున్నారు, లేకపోతే ఏం చేయడానికి వాళ్ళకి ఎటువంటి అవకాశం కల్పించాలి, ఎటువంటి అవసరాలు ఉన్నాయనేది వాళ్ళని కొంచెం క్లోజ్గా అబ్జర్వ్ చేస్తూ ఉంటే మీకు ఇప్పటిదాకా బాధ్యత అంతా మా మీద ఉంది, ఇప్పటి నుంచి బాధ్యత అంతా మీ మీదకి వచ్చేసినట్టే. అయినా కానీ ఏదన్నా అవసరం ఉండి మా తరఫున కేరళ తరఫున ఏదన్నా సహాయం అవసరం ఉండి ఏదైనా చేయగలిగింది కానీ మీరు మాకు చెప్తే మేము కూడా ఎప్పుడైనా సరే అది చేయడానికి సిద్ధంగా ఉంటాం. అటువంటి ఏ రోజు అంటే ఒకసారి ఇక్కడ చదివారు వెళ్ళిపోయారంటే దాంతో మా సంబంధాలు తెగిపోయినట్టు కాదు, జీవితకాలం. ఈ కళాశాల ఉన్నంతకాలం ఇందాక ప్రజలు చెప్పినట్టు, సిద్ధమ్మ చెప్పినట్టు జీవితకాలం మీరు ఈ కళాశాలకి మీరు బంధువులే. మాకు కేఎల్ఆర్ ఫ్యామిలీలో మీరు ఒక భాగం ఉన్నట్టుగానే మేము భావిస్తాము. అలాగే
పోస్ట్ గ్రాడ్యుయేట్ పేరెంట్స్ కానీ లేకుంటే అండర్ గ్రాడ్యుయేట్ పేరెంట్స్ కానీ 5 సంవత్సరాల కాలంలో రకరకాల సందర్భాల్లో మిమ్మల్ని మేము విసిగించుండొచ్చు, మీ పిల్లలు చేసిన చిన్న చిన్న తప్పుల కోసం మిమ్మల్ని పిలిపించుండొచ్చు, లేదంటే మా కాలేజ్ ఆఫీస్ నుంచో ప్రిన్సిపల్ ఆఫీస్ నుంచో మీకు ఫోన్ కాల్స్ వచ్చి ఉండొచ్చు, ఇంకా మరీ ముఖ్యంగా ఫీజు కట్టమని మిమ్మల్ని ఎక్కువసార్లు అడిగి ఉండొచ్చు, లేదా మరీ ముఖ్యంగా ఏదైనా ఎగ్జామ్స్ టైంలోనో అటువంటి టైంలోనో కొంచెం చిన్న చిన్న ఇబ్బందులకు గురై ఉండొచ్చు మీ పిల్లలు. ఇదేవి కూడా మా స్టాఫ్ కానీ ప్రిన్సిపల్ కానీ లేకుంటే ఆఫీస్ స్టాఫ్ కానీ వాళ్ళ సొంత ఆహారంలో చేసింది కాదు, అది ఏదన్నా కానీ మేనేజ్మెంట్ యొక్క అనుమతితో చేసి ఉంటారు. కాబట్టి అటువంటి చిన్న చిన్న తప్పిదాలు ఏమైనా ఉంటే వాటన్నింటినీ పెద్ద మనసు చేసుకొని ఈ మా మేనేజ్మెంట్ క్షమిస్తారని ముఖ్యంగా మీరు చేసిన ప్రతి చిన్న విషయం ఏదైనా చిన్న ఫోన్ కాల్ కానీ లేకుంటే చిన్న డిస్కషన్ కానీ ఏదన్నా కానీ పిల్లల యొక్క అభివృద్ధి కోసమే లేదంటే పిల్లల్ని సరైన దారిలో పెట్టడం కోసం తప్పితే ఎవరికి కూడా ఎటువంటి పర్సనల్ ఉద్దేశాలతో ఎటువంటి సొంత వ్యాపారం కాదు. కాబట్టి మీరు కూడా పెద్ద మనసు చేసుకుని అర్థం చేసుకుంటారని, ఎట్టకేలకు వాళ్ళు కూడా గ్రాడ్యుయేషన్ కంప్లీట్ చేశారు కాబట్టి మీరు సంతోషంగా ఉంటారు, మేము సంతోషంగా ఉన్నాం. సో మీ అందరికీ మరొకసారి కేరళలో ఎన్ఆర్ఐ ఇన్స్టిట్యూట్ ఎంట్రెన్స్ అయిన తరఫున తల్లిదండ్రులందరికీ ఈ కళాశాలను ఎంచుకొని మీ పిల్లల్ని ఇక్కడ చదివించినందుకు పేరు పేరున మరొకసారి ధన్యవాదాలు తెలియజేసుకుంటూ ఈ కార్యక్రమానికి ఇంత కష్టపడి ఇటువంటి సందర్భంలో కూడా వచ్చినందుకు నాకు ఎప్పటికీ ఆశ్చర్యం కలుగుతుంది ఇంతమంది వచ్చారంటే. ఎందుకంటే ఇది పిల్లలు అడిగారు మేము చేయడం జరిగింది. యాక్చువల్గా ఇక్కడ డయాస్ మీద కూర్చున్న వాళ్ళు కానీ కింద కూర్చున్న వాళ్ళు కానీ ఫ్యాకల్టీ కానీ ప్రతి ఒక్కరు కూడా మరొకసారి ఆలోచించండి అని చెప్పారు. అయినా కానీ పిల్లలు అడిగారని చేయడం జరిగింది. అయినా కానీ మీరు కూడా పిల్లలు అడిగారని మీరు వచ్చినందుకు, పిల్లలు అడిగారని మేము చేసినందుకు ఇది సఫలీకృతమైనట్లే. థ్యాంక్ యూ అండి. మీ అందరికీ పేరు పేరున ధన్యవాదాలు తెలియజేసుకుంటూ సెలవు తీసుకుంటున్నాను. ప్రతి గ్రాడ్యుయేటింగ్ స్టూడెంట్ అందరికీ బ్రైట్ ఫ్యూచర్ ఉండాలని, మీరు ఎంతో స్థితిమంతులు అవ్వాలని, ఉన్నత శిఖరాలకు అధిరోహించాలని కేరళ గారి ఆశీస్సులు మీ అందరిపైన ఉంటాయని. ఈరోజు ఈ కార్యక్రమానికి చైర్పర్సన్ నాగమణి మేడం విజయనాథ్ గారు అక్కడ అదే సేమ్ వేరే వాతావరణ కారణాలు అయితేనేమో అక్కడ వేరే ఇన్స్టిట్యూట్లో కొంచెం పని ఒత్తిడి ఉండటం వాళ్ళు విజయలేకపోయారు. చైర్పర్సన్ నాగమణి మేడం గారి తరఫున కూడా మీ అందరికీ ఆశీస్సులు తెలియజేస్తూ, అలాగే తల్లిదండ్రులందరికీ చైర్పర్సన్ గారి తరఫున కూడా ధన్యవాదాలు తెలియజేస్తూ సెలవు తీసుకుంటాను. థ్యాంక్ యూ అండి.
Now I take the privilege of introducing our special guest of the day, Mr. Snehit Reddy Meda sir, who is an entrepreneur in the field of IT-enabled agri-products, marketing and a newest concept of electrical vehicles. He co-founded Pico Agritech Private Limited and Hala Mobility Private Limited. Snehit sir, who is an engineering graduate from prestigious Manipal University, worked initially with Facebook and Cognizant Technologies. Being from a second-generation business family, he opted to be an entrepreneur. His future visualization is seen from his choice of floating an electrical vehicles enterprise, which will be the most sought-after model in near future. Hala Mobility is venturing into multi-modal electrical transportation like two-wheelers and four-wheelers, releasing for rental and buyout and fully IT-enabled. Snehit sir's one more venture of supply chain management for food items under brand name of One Basket is popular for its quality and on-time delivery. On so auspicious occasion of our graduation ceremony 2020, his presence fully will encourage and motivate the graduates to plan and succeed in all their future endeavors. On behalf of Kerala family, we sincerely thank Snehit sir for being here. I request our special guest, Mr. Snehit sir, to address the congregation.
Good evening, everyone. Hello. I know it's a surprise that I'm here as an engineer in a congregation of doctors, but forced perspectives are something which the world is learning. Like, what do I mean by forced perspectives? There was a time ownership was everything in our country. Owning a car was a dream, like everybody's dream. Like your parents' biggest dream probably at one point was owning a car. It has changed in the past 5 to 10 years, if you've noticed it or not. It has changed. It has changed in a big way. Most of us prefer an Uber. What is Uber doing? It is taking your ownership of a car and saying it's owned by everybody. Now everybody pays a service and everybody gets benefited from it. Now, why is it important for doctors to think about transitions or consumerism or just say market capital, social capital, or any such fields, right? One of the few things probably everybody must have heard about is a concept called as automation. Now, most of us don't understand what automation is, but automation is coming. It's coming for engineers as much as it's coming for doctors. There are simple diagnoses which are being done by apps, like tech apps with no background of doctors there, just on pure data. Like there are apps which can diagnose if you have a cold or a fever or a rash, what type of rash, just by looking at series of images. But does this mean that a field of study is gonna go ignorant or like not gonna change about it? That is gonna be a bad answer to the question. The question is, how do doctors fit in, how do engineers fit in for the new wave of big data coming? One of the things that I have noticed throughout my career, like I have worked in Facebook, it's a very prestigious firm. We have built machine learning algorithms to detect whether a person is smiling in an image. Like at this point, you put an image, a computer is gonna tell whether you're smiling or not. But there was humans who told the computer that he was smiling or not. That is the future. Now all the doctors together, the simple parameter here is networking. Knowing what is your benefit to the society and where you stand is what makes the profession special. I can build a machine to run a cycle, to run a car, but I can't do what a doctor does to his patient. Right? The moment you are hurt, you probably first say, Amma. Then if it still hurts, you're like doctor Degarwala. Like a lot of honorary dignitaries here have mentioned, right? Doctors don't come with names. Doctors come as a profession. Right? No matter how much automation comes into the field, that human touch of what a doctor brings is going to be the key for the future, is what we believe in. Like as tech guys, we don't see human emotions as much. We sit behind computers. I have a team of five which run like a million-dollar company, but you can't do the same when it comes to doctors. You can't say, go sit in front of a video camera and I will diagnose you. That is never going to work. We need you to understand that no matter how much tech there is in the world, no matter how much automation happens in the world, the core of it, doctors are there forever. So be proud in what you've achieved. Worry about your future, like all of us do, but be absolutely proud of what you have achieved. Because in this world of ever-changing facets, knowing who you are is very important. And you're all doctors. And that is all I have to say. Be extremely proud of what you've achieved today. Thank you.
Thank you, Sneha sir. You're truly an inspiration to all of us.
Now I request Dr. K. Sridevi ma'am, Professor and Head Department of Oral Medicine and Radiology, to introduce our today's chief guest, Dr. K. Satish Kumar Reddy sir.
Respected distinguished dignitaries on the dais, off the dais, I feel unclear. My dear students and parents, happy good afternoon to you all. With the blessings of the Almighty and our beloved Founder Chairman Kerala Sir, I, on behalf of Lenora Institute of Dental Sciences, take the privilege to introduce our today's chief guest, the simple and humble yet eminent personality with innumerable accolades to his credit, Dr. K. Satish Kumar Reddy Sir. Sir pursued bachelor's in dental surgery in 1984 from one of the five oldest dental colleges of the country, Government Dental College, Hyderabad. Secured state first rank in the PG entrance examination conducted by Government of Andhra Pradesh in 1985. And completed Masters in Orthodontics in 1988 from GDC Hyderabad. Dr. Satish Kumar Reddy sir is a versatile orthodontist with extraordinary skills and worked as a professor, PG guide and director in the Department of Orthodontics and Dentofacial Orthopedics, Sri Sai College of Dental Surgery, Vikarabad, and guided many postgraduates. Sir served as member of Dental Council of India for 10 years, nominated by Government of AP in 2004, unanimously elected as member by NTR University of Health Sciences in 2009. Sir rendered his services as coordinator for the Amendments of Dentists Act 1948 and coordinator for interactive website project of Dental Council of India, coordinator for the new inspection reforma of the Dental Council of India. Sir extended his services as member High Power Committee, Department of Health, Government of AP for 4 consecutive terms from 2004 to 2008 to evaluate applications and recommend to the government for the issue of essentiality certificates in establishing the medical, dental, nursing and VHMS colleges. He also rendered his services as Member Academic Senate, Dr. NTR University of Health Sciences, Andhra Pradesh. Dr. Satish Kumar Reddy sir has several national and international publications to his credit and took part in many national and international seminars, conferences, conventions and symposia. Sir also extends his grace as Director to White Healthcare Private Limited and Director Transcell, a stem cell bank and research center. It would be apt to admit that it is not the post that gives fame to sir, but it is Dr. K. Satish Kumar Reddy sir who brings glory and etches fame to the post. Really we mean it sir. Though a lot more to share, I would like to take pause by stating that sir is currently serving as Dean Lenora Institute of Dental Sciences, member AP Health Reforms Committee and unanimously elected as President AP State Dental Council, where sir showed his mark through the conduction of webinars with wide reach. Sir extended his charity by generously donating large amounts to cut the COVID pandemic. Once again, on behalf of Kerala's Lenora Institute of Dental Sciences, I welcome you, sir, and request you to address the gathering and give away the message.
Management, Inner Institute of Dental Sciences, Madhu, Sindhu, her better half, and Director Nagarjan Reddy, Principal Dr. Shetty, Vice Principal Dalsi, and PG Director Lakshman, and other HODs, and the staff of teaching staff of the Lenora Institute of Dental Sciences, and in particular, the young graduates who have just become graduated and took their degrees in their parents and other guests here. A wonderful evening to all of you. I think it's evening. What all the graduates are so dull, not in terms with me. Feeling hungry? No, we'll spend little time, not long.
because having come all the way, there is a responsibility lies on me to advise a little, and there is a responsibility equally on you to give a little patience here to me. And most unfortunate thing, always chief guest speaks at the last. By the time half are asleep, half will be in a other, you know, other what you call responsibilities to run away from this place. So let us spend a little more time, which may be of some use to you in your life. And to start with, when you have become graduates, I always tell, let us not talk much about the postgraduates because I've been interacting with them. Graduates' point will talk. Because this is the time you are in a crossroad, just completed Babu. Na photo akkala road isunda under big concentrated. See, so a light would have like Ram Babu.
Light is
good. That's good. So ever better. So when you become graduates, it's a wonderful feeling. There are certain, you know, landmarks in life. This is unbeatable. When we are born, we celebrate birthday, but we don't know when we are born, how we are born. It is only a memory what somebody tells. But this is a memory which is going to be a part of your life forever. And you have taken a profession, you have worked hard, you have achieved a target, you have achieved a benchmark in your life, and you must be proud of it, you are proud of it. There is nothing wrong. You have to be proud of it. Now today you are doctors. That's a wonderful feeling. Let this feeling be with you forever. But, don't think, the but comes because till now you are students. Some of you. Till now you are all students pursuing your education under the guidance of all senior staff who are well equipped with knowledge, guidance, everything. Now you are all licensed to treat a patient and you are all independent. From today you are independent, you can treat a patient, you can work on a patient. And when everybody said, and one thing I always feel, we should be thankful to God in this life for giving this opportunity to be a part of this noble profession of medicine. I always thank, every day I thank. See, there may be many professions in life, as Sneh was telling, he might be running a $1 million company with 5 people. No, that's fine. No, everybody will have their own talent, and we welcome it. But what makes difference in our life compared to other techies? See, no, that is good. They do well, they are helping us, that's fine. But there is a component in us which is makes us little different from the others in the world. That is this noble profession. So when you are a part of that profession, see, maybe somebody may be rich, may not be rich, that doesn't matter. You know, as our vice principal is telling, at least we should realize now at the time of COVID. COVID doesn't spare a person with billions or nothing. So it's like this. But the satisfaction when you get, when you are being called as a doctor, the satisfaction when you treat a patient, the satisfaction when somebody says, oh, he's my doctor. I don't know, I have gone through different positions, seen, I have not seen the world like these young people, but country I have seen, I have attended so many places, so many conferences, so many places I have addressed. But every evening when I treat a patient, or some patient comes to my clinic and says, Doc, how are you? That satisfaction will not get anywhere. It is, you cannot calculate with money, with whatever it is. This is a separate feeling. You must enjoy, keep in your mind. But it comes with a responsibility. Any good thing in life comes with a responsibility. A good parenting comes with a responsibility. The parent knows how much struggle they have taken to bring you up. You don't know that. When you have children, then you'll know. Right now you start, you know, murmuring on them, you didn't do that, this and all that. But what kind of the life force that goes behind a parent to bring the child up, only parent knows. You will know after some time, it's not far away. But the thing is, this profession, this doctor degree, this award, and this kind of joy comes with a responsibility that you have to give it back to the society. I'm not saying charity. I'm saying the responsibility. Why I'm insisting this, there is a very important point I'm going to address. You have to understand this. This responsibility is, we cannot simply do some mistake and say, I don't know. Nobody is perfect, but we should do our best. And sometimes we don't know certain things. Don't hesitate to refer to other person when you don't know something. Don't think that patient will run away, you lose your work. Patient will think that you are incompetent. Never. Even now at this age, I refer some patients. When I feel that, I am not very sure of it. I don't feel shy for it. Never my practice has come down. No, and no patient has run away from me. So this is my practical experience. At the same time, keep this responsibility in the mind. And the next chapter, most of you might be thinking what to do. I don't think already, you know, maybe 20-30% of the children might have planned what to do. Most of them otherwise, you don't know what to do. I'll just tell my experience. Most of your professors are from our senior colleagues or junior colleagues in the college. When we graduated about 20-25 years back, don't take it on a negative note, I'm telling you on a positive note. As a graduates, we came out of the college. By the time we came out of the college, we are so well versed with the work. We were ready to start practice, treat patients quite confidently. I just tell you, when I have graduated, I must have done about 1,500 extractions and about 500 to 600, at least 300 impactions. And I have done about 25 fracture immobilizations. That much of exposure, I don't say it's your fault. World has changed, specialties has come, some of the work has been, you know, hijacked by the specialties. When your PG is taking a fracture case, you will not get. When your PG is doing a specialty case, it is not your fault. The world has changed. The kind of exposure one used to get to interact with the patient and treat the patient has changed. So, my feeling, currently I'm telling, I really feel so happy to see so many awards today. And somebody topped university and she's in US, she couldn't come. We really miss her. It is so great. But even then, I can confidently say, attending so many things, you are not still equipped to handle, you know, the social needs of this today. Don't put in a wrong note. Why I am telling you this? The world has changed. The maturity age has changed. So what were we at the age of 25, 26 years with the kind of life and troubles those days and kind of exposure is not the same. It will be the same with my son also. See, you are born and brought up in a much better environment with much more luxury, with less stress. So, don't be in a hurry to start practice. None of you, I'm telling you. It is my word from the heart. Because others might hesitate to say certain things because somebody might take a positive negative. I'm openly telling because I'm not bounded by anybody. I'm telling from the heart, like I'm telling my children. Don't, no practice. If somebody wants not to continue their education, otherwise, you have to do post-graduation. The difference is, in our days, the graduates are superb. When it comes to post-graduation, it is only time pass. Because technology was not developed, equipments were not there, and we were not taught well. So it was not a big advantage being a post-graduate. It is only a degree. So we learn later on in the practice. But nowadays, when I see the graduation, post-graduation education, in any of the institutes, the graduates cannot take up the practice. They are not, whether it is the, you know, I don't say maturity or whatever it is, you are still not geared for the practice. And all the postgraduates 90% are very, very, very good in their performance. He is present, it's you only. So that means you need another 3-4 years of thorough workout, whatever way it is. My advice is, there are enough number of postgraduate seats, prepare well in NEET, take up the post-graduation, some subject you should do it, don't hesitate, that is a must. But I cannot insist on somebody if they have any financial problems or other social problems, other family issues, those things, you know, exceptions. But 70-80% might not be in that category. If that problem is there, at least work in some, under some senior person for at least 2-3 years before you independently take up the work. Because, see, when we are in this profession, as I said, there is a responsibility also. Let us not feel bad. Nothing will happen in 2-3 years. We will get it triple the benefit. Rather than, you know, giving a sorry face to somebody, if we are competent enough to handle anything, what else you need? So, my advice to you is further education. Or, if you are planning to go to other country like your secretary said, that is your will and wish, they'll help you. And if you are want to stop your education here, at least 2-3 years, work under some good guidance. And competence pays. And competition is very heavy, I am telling you. When we started, there is no competition. Today, that competition is there in every field. See, not only dentistry, even engineering, there are many people who are jobless. So that is not our concern. Our concern is our competence. I tell you, in my own clinic, there is a BDS graduate which draws 70,000, there is a BDS graduate which draws 20,000. Well, both are the same degree. It is her competence. She is proving. So half of my job is done. So this is what we have to develop. The technical skills, the patient, especially soft skills. Actually, I told your chairman and secretary they were planning to conduct some courses of soft skills to all of you, but because of the COVID, they couldn't do it. They have a very, you know, organized platform for the, we wanted to run a program to develop your soft skills. And you, all of you can watch Andhra Pradesh State Dental Council website. Right now we are running a program, webinar program, practice management and ethical marketing. All aspects are covering it. But it is not fully a soft skill oriented program. So these webinars you keep watching. Whenever you are free, keep watching. Now I don't say stop your social media. You allocate some time every day for 15-20 minutes for your profession also. This is a learning curve. So this is my important advice to you. Your post-graduation is a must, or else work in some place for 2-3 years. Or if you are going abroad, take the guidance and try to prepare for it. And take the responsibility. Don't run away. And before I close it, I just tell you, in all my meetings, introspection. As a medical practitioner, I don't know, I must have told you in the last graduation day also, how many of you are following, I don't know. Introspection. Introspection is one of the greatest mantra for a doctor to do better. It could be any way. Every day, before going to bed, spend 2 minutes, only 2 minutes, just saying, this fellow has told us, let us try, at least for 3 months. Then if you don't want to leave it, just narrate what all happened from morning to night. What are the good, what are the bad. Don't feel anything for the good or bad. Don't regret anything. Just remember when you got up. What did you do? What has happened? Morning you got up. At 8:30, went to mess. Food is over. You didn't even brush. You ran to the mess. No problem. Then went to the late to the department. Lakshman sir scolded. No problem. Then treated a patient. Bullshit, utter flop, no problem. Okay, then evening, went to the mess, fought with somebody, no problem. Then before going to bed, just narrate for 2 minutes, then you do it every day. After 3 days, morning you'll get up at 7 o'clock, you'll brush and go to the mess, not miss the breakfast. Before Lakshman, you'll be in the department. Okay? No case will mess with you, nor you'll mess with the case. And whatever mistakes we have done, it is self-correcting. We start thinking, we don't have to, when you do introspection, you don't have to worry about it. But what has caused it is you are quite competent enough to say that what has gone wrong with me, why this case went like this. Why I should hear such a lovely person, Lakshman sir, you know, with such a big body scolded me. Then, you know, in the mess, the same thing. Why should I miss my breakfast? Why I went without brushing? So, you automatically change. This is, I'm not asking you to do big exercise. This is a simple thing. This will make you, you know, even now I practice. I come across some cases I fail even now. But next time it will not allow me to fail. And slowly from 90% of your failure it will come to 10%. For a doctor it is very important. What else? Your job is done. What else? If your practice is about 90% successful, what else you need? This is 2 minutes program. After this, I would say personal etiquette, professional etiquette. I don't call, you know, ethics. Because ethics is guidelines written by the official organization, what a doctor should follow, what a doctor should not follow, what is this oath. Some of the words are not, you know, even I cannot understand, you don't understand. Somebody wrote it, we are reading it. But we can understand English and Telugu, and we can understand. What we understand? We are responsible to the society. We are doctors, we are proud of it. We will not commit any mistake. Etiquette is this only. Nobody will come and see whether you have washed your hand and put in the patient mouth or not. But as Sindhu was telling, every bad thing teaches us. Now the COVID has taught us how to be more hygienic. So this is etiquette. If it is your conscience, my patient could be my parent. My patient could be more important to me. So you treat well. This self-discipline is called etiquette. That it has to come from you. It will not come from others. What mistakes inside the body, what we do, after we are licensed, nobody will see. It is only the self, yourself, you should feel that consciousness. It is another important activity. And at the end, never leave fitness. Whatever you do, I don't say you do yoga, I don't say you do cycling, I don't say you run. Whatever you like, anything on earth is fine. A half an hour of physical activity, like Nagarjuna Reddy, see how fit he is. No, just take 10 minutes class with him, lifelong you can remember. Half an hour, don't forget. See, it is not a big job. Either in the morning or in the night or whenever you wish. Why I am telling you is, we suffered. I started my life at 26, by 32 my spine has gone. I am operating at 50%. Having somebody told me I would have done some kind of spinal exercise and all that, I would have not had such a bad, I was 6 months bedridden and 2 years I was away from practice. Don't do that, because that is one of the biggest occupational hazards. I used to work 13 hours a day. This is some madness, you know, I accept, it's not needed. We are all young now, the young blood like you. So we keep shouting when the program is going and we say this useless fellow will be talking something. So this is all part of the age, nothing wrong in it. But you are not as bad as us, so you be better. Okay, with this I thank you for the patient hearing. Sorry for making you hungry. All the best, God bless you.
Thank you, sir. Now I would like to call upon our young graduate, Dr. Pallavi Pandavla, to share her experience.
Good evening, everyone. Respected dignitaries, staff, parents, seniors, and my dear friends, I, Pallavi, feel it a great honor to speak behalf of class of 2020. Thank you all for this true privilege. My hearty congratulations to graduates, postgraduates, and diploma postgraduates. Today is a milestone for each one of us and our families. Right now, it's tempting to try to sum the past 5 years. It was an incredible journey filled with enriching experiences here at Kerala LIDS. I'd like to express my gratitude on behalf of my badge to the management of Kerala LIDS for providing us with the best possible infrastructure and opportunities. I'd like to thank our faculty who bestowed us with knowledge and motivational thoughts that will help us shine in our lives. Heartfelt thanks to our parents and families for their sacrifices and support. My special thanks to seniors, juniors, non-teaching staff, patients, and all who contributed to what we are today. I'm sure each one of us graduating here are experiencing a roller coaster of emotions. It's the day where the feelings of happiness for this achievement and sorrow that we are going to miss this college intertwine together. How lucky it is to have something that makes it so hard to say goodbye, our college, isn't it? It would be nice if you could pack up everything we learned and experienced here, fix a little handle on it, carry with us onto the shiny shrine of the future to say this was the best time at Kerala LIDS, wasn't it great? I truly believe that with all water management and staff gave us at Kerala LIDS, we are going to be a blessing for ourselves and people around us. Wish you all the very best at this juncture. Let us try to give our best to our profession. I wholeheartedly thank our management staff once again, behalf of my batch Falcons, for making our journey a great one here at Kerala LIDS. We'll be always your students forever. Thank you each one for giving me this wonderful opportunity on this post session day. Thank you everyone.
Thank you, Pavan. Thank you, Pallavi.
I request Mr. Y. Madhusudan Reddy sir to kindly can state today's guest along with the other dignitaries on the list.
కొంచెం ఆటో ఇటరా మొత్తం కెమెరా నా పెట్టను
sir. Isn't it very rewarding to see that you all have crossed one more important milestone in your life? The saying goes that without pressure, there can be no diamonds. You will face new, exciting challenges in every part of your life. On behalf of KLR's Lenora Institute of Dental Sciences, we wish you every success for your future. Congratulations and good luck.
I request Dr. V. Dal Singh sir to deliver the vote of thanks.
Good evening once again. Respected dignitaries, my dear colleagues and graduates, and my dear parents, on behalf of Lenora Institute of Dental Sciences, I feel it's my privilege to propose word of thanks on this occasion. I take this opportunity to extend my gratitude and sincere thanks to today's chief guest, Dr. Satish Kumar Reddy sir, for consenting to be part of this grand ceremony despite of this pandemic going on. Thank you so much, sir. I wish to express my gratitude and sincere thanks to Chairperson Madam, though she is not here, for constant support and her efforts towards the continuing growth of this institute. Thank you, Madam. I thank Mr. Snehit Reddy garu, special guest, for gracing this occasion and inspiring our students. I thank our beloved secretary, KLR Group of Institutions, Madhusudan Reddy sir, who is instrumental in the progress of this institute and making this event a grand success. Thank you so much, sir. I thank our young and energetic treasurer, KLR Group of Institutions, Sindhu Garu, for gracing the occasion and inspiring our young graduates. I express sincere thanks to the head of the institute, Principal Dr. Vishwaprakash Shetty sir, Director Nagarjun Reddy sir, PG Director Lakshman Rao sir, for your help and support and guidance during conduction of this event. And all the heads of the departments for support, suggestions and in the conduction of this event. Thank you. An event like this cannot happen overnight, and such a task is fulfilled by all the teaching and non-teaching staff. To mention few, Dr. Sridevi Madam, Lakshman Rao sir, Dr. Vaishnavi, Dr. Jacob, Dr. Amruta, Dr. Punita Madam, Lalita Garu, Deepa, Dr. Akhil, Dr. Anvesh, Dr. Jesse, Sujata, Satish Garu, and all the basic sciences faculty, Finance Officer Sagar Reddy Garu, Chief Librarian Rambabu Garu, Ramesh Garu, Dhanraj, Nandavu, and today's Masters of Ceremony, Bula and Soumya, and all the supporting staff. Last but not least, for graduates and parents, for your parents sitting and coming all the way to grace this occasion. Thank you so much. Once again, hearty congratulations to all of you. Please be seated. National.
Thank you, sir.
Where is my mask?
Now I request Dr. Ravi Chandana to come onto the stage to receive her graduation certificate. Dr. Ravi Chandana, along with her parents.
Sir, sitting this one. Teacher, sit with the
I request PG students to come onto the stage for a group photograph. PG students and diploma together. All the parents and graduates, please be seated. PG students and diploma students, come onto the dais, please. Make it fast.
Okay, Babu.
All the PGs, please be seated in your corresponding places. UGs, come. Please come in a line. Front row. Boys, come forward and sit here. One row can stand here. Figure kuchun. Boys, come forward. దయచేసి కూర్చోండి. అఫీషియల్ మంచి ఫోటోగ్రాఫ్ వస్తుంది మీకు, దీనికంటే మీరు తీసుకున్న దానికంటే. దయచేసి కూర్చోండి.
Thank you. పుట్టు
సార్
ఒక్క నిమిషం అందరూ ఎలా ఉండండి
ఓకేనా
సార్ ఓకే సార్ ఇంకా వెనక్కి రావాలి ఓకే ద్వారా కొంచెం మీరు కొంచెం వెనక్కి కెమెరా ఓకే రైట్ ఓకే సార్ రైట్
స్మైల్
వన్ మోర్
స్మైల్